Another kind of synchronization primitive that is very popular in multi-threaded parallel programs and extremely useful in developing applications, especially in the scientific domain, is what is called a barrier synchronization. The idea here is that there are multiple threads, and they're doing some computation, and they want to get to a point where they want to know where everybody else is at that point of time. And they want that assurance that everybody has reached a particular point in the respective computations so that then they can all go forward from this barrier to the next phase of the computation. Now, I'm sure that you've gone to dinners with your friends, and one of the experiences that you may have had is that you may have a party of four or five people that are going for dinner. Two or three of you are showing up at the dinner restaurant. And the usher says, wait, you know, do you have the entire members of your party here? If they're not here, wait till the other members of the party show up so that I can seat you all at the same time. That's the sort of same thing that's happening with barrier synchronization. It is possible that, you know, thread T1 and T2 arrive at the barrier, meaning that they've completed their portion of the work. They've gotten to this barrier, but there are other threads that are lagging behind. And those shirkers are going to eventually show up, but they're not here yet. And until everybody shows up, nobody can advance to the next phase of the computation. So that's the idea behind barrier synchronization, exactly similar to this analogy that I mentioned to you. So we looked at two types of synchronization primitives. One is the lock, and the other is the barrier synchronization. Now, these are concepts I am expecting that you know already. If you find that these two concepts are either new to you or you would like some refresher for that, I strongly advise you to go and take a look at the review lesson that we have on multi-threaded programming. Now that we understand the basic synchronization primitives that are needed for developing multi-threaded applications on a shared memory machine, it's time now to look at how to implement them. But before we do that, let's do a quiz to get you in the right frame of mind.